Hi. If you watched the previous video, you'll recall that I ran the simple VST host program with some plugins other than the VSTX synth plugin. VSTX synth worked fine, but none of the others did. So that was a pretty awful day as far as this project was concerned. But all those errors have now been fixed, and in this video I'm going to show you how. I will take each one in turn, starting with the Yamaha plugin, which did not produce any sound. The program did not crash, but no sound was heard. On this flashback of yesterday's test run, you can see that the output is zeros all the way through. To be honest, I stumbled upon the solution just by trying something out that looked as if it might have something to do with the problem. In my plugin object, in the process MIDI events function, memory is reserved for the events, and the events are copied into that memory space. Then, in the call to the plugin's dispatcher, a pointer is passed to those events. The plugin processes the events, and I thought once that's done, I can free up the memory. As it turns out, the Yamaha plugin, and only the Yamaha plugin, none of the others I tried, seems to need those events to persist and be still available at the output generating stage. When they are not, it just produces silence. So in the corrected version, the events are not deleted in this function. They are recycled after output has been generated. The problem with Synth 1, which is a very nice plugin by the way, was to do with the installation of the sound banks, so it was unrelated to the simple VST host program. Now it's going to get interesting. Remember, in the first episode, when I talked about the host callback function, I said when the plugin communicates with the host, also called Audio Master, it uses opcodes to encode references to information. If you don't remember this, or heaven forbid, skip the first video altogether, then it would be useful to revisit it. I'm going to run the program with the Sinister plugin again and recreate the error. As you can see, the error message doesn't tell us much, and the memory access violation happened in the plugin. The clue is not here, but in the console output. As you can see, the plugin was sending these opcodes, and in the host callback function, I didn't cater for them. In this Steinberg header file, we can locate these opcodes. 7 is Audio Master get time, and 23 is Audio Master get current process level. Back in the now extended host callback function, the Audio Master get time request is fairly complex. I won't spend time on explaining it, I leave it to you to research it. Refer to Steinberg's documentation. I showed where it is in my first video. The great thing is that by handling the Audio Master get time opcode, not only this, but also some other plugins began to operate properly. However, DSK Dynamic Guitars had another issue. In the Play MIDI Tune method, when I reserved memory for the plugin's output data, I did that for the number of channels my program was designed for, which was 2, the 2 channels of stereo. The other plugins I worked with also produced stereo output. But DSK Dynamic Guitars happened to generate output for 16 channels, and that caused a memory violation problem. So now, in my program, I query the plugin for the number of outputs it has, and reserve memory accordingly. The next plugin on my list is Roland Sound Canvas VA. I paid money for this plugin. I bought a lifetime license on Roland Cloud. Roland pisses me off because even though I'm not renting but actually purchased the program, they still force me to re-register or reactivate it every 4 weeks or so. Otherwise, it just stops working. As it was some groundbreaking new technology that needs to be so rigorously protected, not. These sounds and effects have been in almost every Roland keyboard and sound card since the mid-1990s. I mean, talk about many ways to skin a cat. Anyway, for this plugin to work faultlessly, I had to include a case statement in the host callback function for the AudioMaster get directory opcode. It wasn't necessary to return a valid path string just to handle the request at all. You see how intricate some problems are? Just for good measure, I'm also handling a couple of other requests, like a sample rate and a block size. I recommend keeping an eye on the opcodes the plugin you are working with requests when you are running the program. It can happen at various stages. This is what this line is doing here. For the rest of the video, I'm just going to run the program with every plugin you see here. Next time, I will improve the program so that it plays the music truly in real time, as the output is being generated by the plugin, and not after the fact, as here. So see you then.